Here I have a PS5 and it makes a beeping sound, but it doesn't turn on. Let's open up this machine here. You just lift up on the corner and give it a little tap. Same on the other side. I'm gonna get down to the, it could be a power supply issue. Or a bad connection, who knows. There is one hidden screw at the top that has a screw. Take out the CPU fan. Thank you. Yeah? Hit you?
Yeah, she hit me. So she had something and she hit me with it out of her top.
Amory?
She's grabbing my back. So, this one you just push this down, pull it out, and black and white, okay. Okay, let me have some black screw that we had to remove here so that we can get to the bottom. Okay. Alright, now it's the tedious work of removing all these screws here. Thank you.
not sure. It's either the power supply. I'll be measuring the voltage here, and I have the motherboard open so I can kind of see what's going on. So let's plug it in. Okay, so I can measure the voltage right here and here. Measuring 12 volts, which is good. Let's see. Just made a beep, nothing. Measuring 5 volts here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my power supply and disconnect 12 volts directly to the power pins. Okay, let's see this. Measuring 12 volts, still doesn't turn on, so I highly doubt that it's a power supply issue. So in standby I'm getting 46 milliamps. I have 12 volts connected to my power supply, and so you have F7002 on the inductor at the top. You can see I'm measuring 3.3 volts standby. Okay, that's good. And over here on this one, you measure 2 volts. On the caps, 2 volts. On these small caps right here, 3.3. In the middle here, you measure 5. That's the main power rail, I presume. Yeah, so it goes 5 and then it goes down to 2, and this is 3 for this one. For this one, there is a cap that you get 1.8, and on the bottom one, you can actually start the PS by shorting out the little resistor that goes to the connector here. It'll make a beep sound. And then you'll get 1 volt. So it turns on and then turns off. What else do we got? Solid 12 volt rail on these caps. So I found one area is F7001. This fuse, if I put it in diode mode, you should get, and it looks like it's a blown fuse. I'm getting like 20k. Not too sure what happened there, but that is a blown fuse at S7001, and if you try another fuse on the board, like here's F7003, right here's the fuse, right? You should measure really like 1.9 ohms. Okay. So, sorry, it wasn't this, the fuse is over there. And I'm measuring good voltage everywhere, so I'm thinking to inject 5 volts on the right hand side of the fuse. So these two capacitors right here were getting warm. I'm thinking it could be them. So that second guy looks mighty dry. Yeah, you can see it just absorbing the heat. So I think that second capacitor there is bad, and it's up by F7502. So I think that's our bad cap. This guy right here. Range 50 ohms on this guy. I don't know if that was. Okay. If you want to know where it is, this is the where the fuse was, F001. That's the blown fuse. And just inject voltage right here and feel around. I know one guy, he found a blown cap in here. In my case, it was the second guy right there, and that seems to have fixed the problem. Yeah, so let's give this a whirl. See if it works. Yeah, and you can see it comes on there. So it's probably going to work now. Wonderful. So here I have it plugged in. It's turning white. And then it gives you the PS5 wasn't turn off properly, so it looks like it's good to go now. All right, so that should be good now.
Thanks for watching this video. Hope it helped out. If you enjoy electronics or want to learn about how to fix electronics, consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.